Hey guys, how's it going? It is Matt McNeil again. I figured I would check in just with another quick tip that might help some of you guys out. Something that was shown to me and it's something that never occurred to me, but now I have employed it on actually all three of the display masks that I've done this summer. And it's one of those things that I find really, really helpful. And it's in regard to the mouth or nose or any other area that needs to appear cavernous and black without actually having quite the depth that it appears to have. If you look at this guy here, you can see, what is that in there? Oh, the light's actually catching the paint because the paint has a slight reflective quality to it, right? So how do you get rid of that for this? And if you look, this guy, and this guy are all done with the exception of this one. And I left him just so that I could show you the difference, right? So again, you see in there, you might be able to sell that as, oh yeah, no, that's just his tongue reflecting the light. But you have to admit that this is so much better, right? It's completely black in there. How do you do it? All right, here's how I was told to do it. What you do is you get some good old Elmer's glue like this, and I have a lot of it because I've been doing a lot of this stuff, and then you get this kind of thing, which is made for balding dudes, and what they do is they sprinkle the flocking, for lack of a better word, it's fibers, into their hair so it makes their hair look full. Well, what's also nice about this is it is completely matte. It is shineless, and it absorbs literally all of the light. So what do? I take a brush and I paint the interior of the mouth wherever I want the fibers to stick with Elmer's glue. And then I take the mask, I set it in my lap, and I sprinkle the fibers all in the mouth, making sure that all the glue is covered. You put more in there than you think you need, shake it all around, make sure that it gets good and covered. And when it has just a few, you know, just a minute amount of time to actually set, you just blow it out. Just blow it out. And what will be left is an awesome, shineless, non-specular mouth interior. Now, you can also do this for interiors of noses and ear holes or any other place on your mask that you want it to be pitch black, where you don't want there to be any kind of reflective quality at all. So you'll end up with this and not that. So anyway, hope that helps somebody. There you go. Talk to you guys later.